All right, that was the Bob Seger System with their 1968 song, 2 plus 2 equals question mark. That is an anti-war protest song, and that was released later on their album Ramblin' Gamblin' Man. And I didn't really know about Bob Seger System before I was looking up... Basically, I was looking up anti-war songs from the same year as the Beatles' anti-war song we're going to be listening to today. And I thought Bob Seger was, you know, I just know Bob Seger and the Silver Bullet Band. So it's cool to hear Bob Seger's System has a little bit more of a psychedelic rock sound to it. That's a pretty cool song. I like it. Hi, my name is Bean, and you're watching Battle of the Band. We're on day 80 of the Beatles tournament. And if you're not familiar with the Beatles tournament, basically what we did was we took every single Beatles track, threw them into a single elimination style tournament, and then we just make them face off head to head until we know which song is the very best Beatles song in the end. We're on day 80, so that means we've got a good 48 days left in round one. 47 or 48. I think it's 48 because we had a bye in the first round. So we're getting there. We're almost done with the first round. It's only like another month and a half or something like that. First up from the Beatles, we have the first track from their album Beatles for Sale, which was actually the fourth album they released in a span of 18 months. They were just popping them out like crazy back then. This is known as being one of the first of four songs written by Lennon, all dealing with a spurned, jilted lover. And this is actually considered to be one of the top 100 Beatles songs, according to what? I don't know. Basically, the song structure repeats itself in many of their future songs, so this song's notable for kind of formulating a lot of the future Beatles stuff beyond this point. This came out in 1964. And that's going up against Revolution 1, which is track 5 off of their self-titled double LP. That is from 1968. That album is also known as the White Album in many circles. And there are a few songs called Revolution by the Beatles. This one is Revolution 1. It was the first version that was recorded. There was another version that was recorded as well that was made as a single, basically. And that one's a lot more like fast and hard rocking than this version that we're going to listen to. I love Revolution 1, though. This is a really good track. Again, the White Album is kind of just like, for a while, it was my favorite Beatles album until I started listening to, you know, all the other albums and figuring out what I really liked best out of the Beatles. This sound in particular is one of the things I really like best out of the Beatles. So, let's get into it. I should mention, if you are new here, we are going to play the songs backward with a bit of distortion. I mostly do that to torture my listeners, making you feel like you're truly in a hellscape suitable for a Beatles fan. Or maybe someone that hates the Beatles. Somebody hates the Beatles. You could play the Beatles forward and it would be hell for them. Someone that does love the Beatles, playing them like this is going to piss you off real quick, especially if it's for eternity. First up, we've got No Reply.
Oh, yes, sir.
Alright, that's an okay song. Kind of creepy, just like, it's kind of got these obsessive lyrics. Definitely a little questionable when he's like, I nearly died because you held some other dude's hand. You need to chill out a little bit, maybe. And the bridge, if I were you, I'd realize that I love you more than any other guy. Just kind of, you know, the type of thing that makes you sound like maybe a little more creepy these days than it did back then. Romance was different back then, I guess. I don't know. I like the chorus parts. The chorus parts were decent. That was probably the best part of the song. And the hand claps. Love hand claps. Let's go ahead and get right into Revolution 1, though.
Yeah.
right. All right. I love that song. A lot of instruments in there, actually. They had a full horn section set up, two trumpets and four trombones. Of course, John Lennon doing the main vocals. Yoko was actually on that song a little bit, doing percussion with Ringo. Ringo on his full drum kit, of course, as well. And Paul's playing keys of all sorts. He's got a piano, he's got organ, and he's doing his bass, of course. Pretty cool. There's just there are backing vocals by the other Beatles, minus Ringo. But, you know, they got Ringo on percussion and drums. He's doing what he needs to be doing here. I really like that song. And one part I never really realized before, in the first pre-chorus, he says, "But when you talk about destruction, don't you know that you can count me out in?" He says "in" right after he says "out." So he is kind of alluding to maybe violence in some ways can help the revolution. But overall, the song is definitely about trying to be a pacifist to end the war. And I know that he's talking about Vietnam War here just because of the time period. And you know, these songs can apply to just about any war going on currently. I don't like to get too political here though, so we'll just stop right there. I'm gonna go ahead and give that one to Revolution One. I just think it's a really groovy song, super good stuff. I like it a lot more than No Reply. No Reply kind of is just, it's kind of creepy. Got social media if you want to talk about it. We've got Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. We've also got a TikTok where you can watch little bits of these videos without having to watch the whole thing. I was wrong earlier when I was saying that Cameron's just showing the results in those things, though, so you're going to have to watch these to figure it out, see what actually came through. Or you can just vote yourself. You know, you don't have to listen to what I say. I do link these songs down below, so if you're not a big fan of playing them backwards and distorted, you can just click the link down below and listen to the Beatles songs normally. I also add annotations at the top that, or whatever they're called. They're cards. They're like cards up at the top that pop up whenever the song starts. You can click those and it'll play the, it'll also lead you to the song played normally. The same song I'm linking in the video or in the description down below. I also link the tournament brackets down below so you can check those out. See how far we are along and what we've got coming up next. You can like this video if you like to also. In fact, I encourage it. Subscribe to the channel if you think it's a pretty cool channel and you like the concept of music tournaments. I'm having a lot of fun, and I think a lot of people are having a lot of fun with this topic, basically. And we've got different bands coming up in the future. I've got other content I'm working on, but it's been stressful. Let's just say that. Share this video with your friends and family, and share it with your local military recruiting office, and see what they think of revolution and a peaceful solution to war. Comment down below with which song you would have picked out of these two, and we could talk a little bit about it down there. And also, just let me know how you feel about pacifism in general. Like, are you a pacifist? I don't hit people. I guess I'm a pacifist. I just talk shit. Have a great day, a nice night, and a wonderful afternoon. I'll see y'all tomorrow for some more Beatles and Butthole Surfers stuff. We're starting round 3 of the Butthole Surfers tournament tomorrow, so that's super exciting. Bye. We're coming down below with what you would have. Jeff Emmerich. He probably just says take 2. Oh, I see. Share it with your military. We're on day 80 of the you almost had it too. I know. Since the Cold War ended. So where should we go from here?